What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and today I want to answer a question that I got from a reader of mine about how to take a hint when you are in your interview. So we all know that this is a thing, right? Where we're going through our interview and our interviewer may give us a hint on how to solve the problem more effectively. And one of the most important things is knowing how to use those hints as productively as possible, because one of the worst things that you can do in your interview is to not use the hints that your interviewer is giving you. Because this becomes one of those things where not only are they potentially deducting points from your overall score because they gave you a hint in the first place, but now they are thinking even more so that you're not listening to them, that you're not actually able to use those hints. And so it really changes their perception of you, and it changes how they are going to review your interview and how they are going to treat that. So this is really, really important. The question that I actually got was that he was in an interview and the interviewer suggested to me a wrong way to solve the problem, which led to more confusion and led to him not being able to solve it. He was really embarrassed by this because he was not able to complete the question. And so his core question is, what do I do when my intuition says that what the interviewer is asking is actually confusing more than it is helping, right? So what do I do if the hint that my interviewer is giving me is not actually a productive hint? And so I want to give you three specific tips today for how to use those hints, how to make sure that you're using them as effectively as possible in your interview, because again, it's so important that we be able to use these hints effectively. So the first thing that I highly recommend that you do, and one of the reasons why we tend to find hints so difficult to use, is I recommend that you take a step back from the problem. Because a lot of times what I see people do, and I'll see this when I am offering hints, is that they try and take the hint and they try and apply the hint very directly to the specific thing that they're doing. And a lot of times, sometimes this is the case that you may be stuck on some very like granular point where the hint is designed to help you with that. But more often than not, I'm giving hints to an interviewee because they are kind of going the wrong way with the problem. And so it's not necessarily that they're doing something completely wrong, but it could just be that they are taking an inefficient approach to the problem. And I'm trying to hint them and get them to go in a different direction so that it's going to be easier for them to solve the problem. And so what you want to do is you want to take a step back and look at the hint in the context of the entire problem. Because it's easy to say, oh, well, I was doing this very specific thing, so that hint totally doesn't make sense. Right? Like, why would you be suggesting that? That doesn't make sense in the context of what I was doing. And that may be true, but that doesn't mean that the hint is not helpful. That doesn't mean that the hint isn't something that you want to apply more generally to the problem. So step number one, take a step back and try and look at the hint more holistically. Look at like, how does this hint apply to the problem as a whole? And how does it apply? How could I maybe change my overall approach to the problem to use this hint and to more effectively solve the problem? So that's number one. Now, number two, and these last two are getting a bit more into this specific question that I was asked, is number two is it's really important to understand what is the hint that the person is actually giving you, right? And I see this a lot, is that interviewers will give these kind of cryptic hints, or they're trying to essentially give you a hint without just giving away the solution to the problem. And so sometimes they'll ask very cryptic things, or they'll ask leading questions, but they're not really telling you anything meaningful. And so it's on you to clarify and really understand what it is that they're giving you, what that hint is, and how that can apply. So this is a great opportunity for you to take their hint and try and like rephrase it and like put it back to them. Basically, you know, can you rephrase it and get them to sort of confirm that that is in fact what they're saying? Because if you can get them to do that, then you can make sure that you're really understanding the hint. Because one of the worst things that you can do, and this is the same as like, it's the same as like solving the wrong problem, right? Whereas if you have this hint that they gave you and you're not understanding it correctly and you're trying to apply it in one way, but they meant something else, it can actually take you further away from what they are expecting you to do, from the problem that you're actually trying to solve. And so it's super important, again, that you think about like, am I applying this the proper way? Am I understanding what they're asking? And then the third point, number three, and this is really, if you're getting super confused by the hints, if you're really not understanding, ask for clarification. It's so important that, again, I think a lot of times in the interview, we tend to think that it's this combative thing where it's like that we have to prove ourselves to the interview. Anytime we ask for hints, anytime we express confusion about something, anytime that we don't, you know everything immediately, we're automatically failing the interview, and that's just not good enough, right? We kind of have this impression of the interview that we just have to demonstrate, you know, perfection all the time, and that's just not true. And the problem that leads to is that, in theory, yes, the best interview is where you get the response, it's perfect, you code up everything just exactly the way that they wanted to, without any hints, without anything, yada, 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 right? But in practice, just because you got a hint, or just because you got a little stuck on something, doesn't mean that you automatically failed your interview. A lot of people will like, their interviewer will give them a hint, and they'll automatically be like, oh my God, I failed. And then they'll go down this like death spiral in the interview of, you know, anxiety, thinking that they already screwed up. So, you know, and that making them perform worse and worse and worse. And so it's really important that you don't do that. And that you also realize that you can ask for clarification. You can talk to your interviewer. You can say, this doesn't make sense to me. I'm not sure what you're asking. Can you maybe phrase it in a different way? There's so many things that you can say to them when you are confused, when you are stuck, that you don't have to just sit there and be stuck. Right, you don't have to just, it's not your burden to bear. You're allowed to ask for clarification. You're allowed to ask for more. And so those are the three things that I would encourage you to do when you get a hint during your interview. One, take that step back, really look at it holistically and understand what it is that they are suggesting. Understand how it fits into the context of the entire problem rather than just trying to like shoehorn it into exactly what you're doing. Number two, make sure that you understand exactly what they're asking. And number three, ask for clarification when you don't. Really use this opportunity to communicate with your interviewer, ask them questions, understand, and don't let this get you down. Don't assume that because they're giving you a hint that you automatically failed, that you're not gonna be able to be successful in this interview. And with that, that's all I got for you today. Make sure that you do use these hints to your advantage because it's a great resource in your interview. And if you haven't already, make sure that you go to bytebybyte.com/50questions and download our free 50 coding interview questions guide where we cover 50 of the most common coding interview questions that you'll see in your interview. Awesome guide. We've had more than 10,000 people download at this point. Really good resource for you. And I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.